I'm going live because I actually did make dinner and I did it in the microwave. I came home from work and then I went straight. I loaded this stuff in the microwave pressure cooker. And I know Roberta, so if it's really, really bothersome, just log off. And I don't know what to tell you guys on Facebook. So I'm live on Instagram, I'm live on Facebook. I'm slowly gonna start converting over just to Instagram because Facebook has given me so much problems. It's super frustrating. So this is what I put in here. I kind of just MacGyvered it because I didn't know what to make for dinner. And Romel defrosted all this meat, but I'm like, I don't know what to make. So this is just pork shoulder. I put it in here with maybe a cup and a half of water. Hi, everybody. Before I forget, hi, everybody. I do see you. I just want to get this out so that I give you guys what it was I did in here. And I know that it's dark in my kitchen. I got rid of my lighting in here because I wasn't doing videos much. Oh, you're in the Philippines. Paul Benda, real screamer. Hi, Kelly. Hi, guy. Let me see. Hi, Laura. Okay. So I put about 2.5 pounds of pork shoulder. I just cut it in big slabs and I threw it in the microwave pressure cooker. And then I put about 1.5 cups of water. And then I put about 1 tablespoon to 2 tablespoons of vinegar, because the vinegar helps to tenderize the meat really well. And then I put about 1 cup of sweet baby Ray's barbecue sauce. That was it. I put I did put a little bit of salt, like Hawaiian salt. And I did put a little bit of sugar because of the vinegar. But I just threw it all in here, did it for 25 minutes, and then I ran out of the house and I had my nails done. I went to go get my nails done. They're not very long. So can you guys see it? So I'm feeling pretty. Got my nails done. It's very short. Hi, Kenny Hooney. Very short. Very, like, natural. I still got a type, that's why. And, like, yeah. So just short, square, basic kind nails. So I did that. So I'm going to take this with a pair of tongs, if I can find it. It's probably my dishwasher. Because I want to show you guys how tender this thing came out. So I did it for 25 minutes. Pork shoulder. What I was gonna do was just shred the meat, and then and it probably needs to go in for another round because I went to go do my nails. Then I literally just came home. So anything you see, this brown caramelized part, anything that's like above the waterline in the pressure cooker is gonna do that. It's not really burnt, I wouldn't say. It just gets caramelized because it's not submerged in liquid. But I do want to see how soft this is, because if I can shred this thing up, I'm just going to put a little bit more of the barbecue sauce on top of it. And I was just going to put this in between pandesal. So it's going to be like a slider. Hi, everybody. So let's just try. I didn't want to make it like, so if I was going to do like Kahlua pig in this, you can kind of just fork the meat. Can you guys see? I know it might be hard. Kenny, just tell him, hi, RJ, I'm Kenny, and you can tell him that you're the guy from the commercials for the storage place. Didn't you do a commercial for them? If you guys don't know, Kenny Hooney is on Instagram for the guys on Facebook. Hi, Alex, hi, Mallory, hi, Jane, hi, Malia. So 25 minutes. You can shred the meat. I mean, it could be more. I mean, if I put it in for another 10, 15 minutes, it'll be like disintegrated. So I don't want it to be disintegrated. I want it to have some, like, this is almost like pork adobo kind tender. 25 minutes, a full slab. It was defrosted, but if you have frozen meat, this works the same. I have made pork adobo from frozen meat in about 40, 45 minutes using this, because like sometimes Romel doesn't think about me. So I'm gonna be honest, the outside parts are super soft. The middle is still could use a little bit more time. So I'm just gonna shred what I can, but it is cooked all the way through. And I do have to taste it. I know Romel, he's super picky. So he's gonna want it super, super extra tender. So I'm just gonna take that part out. I'm gonna rotate the meat. Like, I don't know. I don't like it where it's this super disintegrated and it doesn't have like texture to it. But Rommel does. Cause this was like pretty fat pieces of pork. So let me flip this over and I'm gonna put this back in the microwave for like 15 minutes. Experiment. But that's all I put. So for those of you guys who popped on late, I put a little bit of vinegar and it's just this in the pressure cooker. Sometimes you just gotta MacGyver things, you know? I wasn't in the mood tonight to just stay home and I wanted to go get my nails done, so that's what I did. So let's do 15 minutes. Just so you know, for those of you who are new to this, you still need to wait 10 minutes before you can pop them open because the pressure. Hi, Paca. Everybody say hi, Paca. It's been a minute. So while that's cooking, let me taste it because maybe it needs more salt or sauce or whatever. And Rommel is back to paddling. This thing is good. Oh my God, it doesn't need any more. But then again, Rommel likes everything salty. Hi, Jessica on Facebook. I am forking hard meat. Don't y'all like to fork hard meat? Paca, everybody hasn't seen me cook in forever. But I think I'm getting a little bit more settled in my job. And the 50th event is POW. That I think I'm ready to like get back into the groove again. Okay, let me try again. Can you guys see it? So I'm gonna cook it for another round of 15 minutes. Cause did you see how big those slabs were? It's really good. Oh my God. This sauce is the bomb. Okay, let me try to put some more. By the way, no, this is not keto. Ooh. I made the bottle excited. No, it's not keto. If you're doing keto, this is not it. And I really don't want anybody busting my balls about it not being keto either. I'm not doing that anymore. I just eat to live. Thank you, Christine. I did do the King's Runner yesterday and I like ran my fat ass off. Oh my God, that sauce is so good. Oh my God. Right here, this is the winner barbecue dinner. So Paca, we're literally just gonna shred the meat and put it in pandesal, or Rommel can eat it with rice. And I got this pandesal from my Auntie Marissa in Murrieta, California. She shipped a whole bunch of it to us. I have a bunch in the freezer. It's Tasty Cake Bake Shop is what it's called. I'm just going to toast it in the toaster oven and slow this and the kind. Hi, Hero JR. Thank you for watching. Okay, so Facebook, I know it's like freezing. Bussing up, it's annoying. If you guys are on Facebook, I apologize. Instagram, I think, is the way to go now because Facebook's giving me issues. Okay, hold on, I'm gonna disconnect my Facebook. I don't know what's wrong. Paca, did you jump on the Facebook first and then come to Instagram? I'm telling you, I don't know what's wrong with it. Okay, so I have a story to share with you guys. Are you guys ready? Okay, hold on. My neighbors are probably thinking I'm freaking mental. You make food look so good. Because it is good. You know who's the best though is Rommel. Because Rommel, he gives you guys that suspense. Like he eats it and doesn't say a damn thing for like 3 minutes. You're hardly on Facebook. See, I'm. You know what? I feel like it's time to start migrating everything over to Instagram. That's just how I feel about it. Like Facebook's just been jamming up. Okay, so you want to hear my story? Here's my story. This morning was pretty rough. I mean, it's like post party, yeah? So the party is done. It's back to work. We got to unload all the party stuff, the banners, all that stuff, put them all away. And then the leftover favors, what are we going to do with it? It was just a rough morning. So I'm like, okay, I think I'm going to take a break. I'm going to run out and go get breakfast. So I run out with a coworker. We're gonna go to Alakea Steaks. If you guys know what that is, they have like really cheap food. No, it's not healthy. No, I wasn't going for healthy either. I was like, screw it, I'm hungry. Nobody wants me hangry at work, not today on a Monday. So I went and I got the burrata moco. That's what it's called. And it's corned beef with onions on rice, covered in gravy, with two eggs over medium. And I had two sides of hash browns because I love hash browns. Not gonna apologize for that. Anyway, I was having a rough morning. I needed a break, so I walked outside. I'm waiting at the corner at the light, pushing the button, you know, to cross the street. And I thought I felt like a heavy raindrop. So I was like, what is that? And I went like this, right? But it wasn't raining. So I'm like, what was that? So my coworker goes, oh my God, I think a bird pooped on you. Mind you, the whole morning I was messaging Romel telling him what a freaking horrendous morning it's been, and it's only 8 o'clock. So a bird shit on me and it caught me like over here. So I'm like, oh my God, no. She goes, yeah, but I can't see it. So it wasn't like that white pigeon shit. It was something else. So we go across the street. We're going to the restaurant. I couldn't smell it. I didn't know what it looked like. I didn't have a mirror. And so, hi, Kaleopu'u. That's Emily's school. And so, right, ew is right, girl. So we get in the restaurant. There's no napkins to be had because there's a lot of homeless that walk around. They don't just leave it out. So my friend's like, can we get a napkin? So she grabs the napkin and starts touching it. Mary's and gentlemen's. As soon as she went like this, I was like, I'm like, is this really bird doo-doo or is it human? Because the bugger was stank. And when she went like this, it wasn't white poop. It was not white. Whatever color the thing was, but the freaking thing was, how not? Now I lost my appetite. So I'm like, oh my God. And I'm waiting for my girlfriend to order because I told it. Luckily, there was nobody in the restaurant, like sitting down eating. And they had a ginormous jug of hand sanitizer in the corner. So she gives me a couple napkins. She starts, but the bugging, the one napkin she put was soaking with bird crap. So we threw it in the trash. So I grabbed the rest and I'm cleaning it. And I'm just like, oh my God, it's not getting better. Like, I just feel like I'm smearing it. So, and I don't have a mirror and I didn't want to make it super obvious because we're in a restaurant. So I'm like waiting for her to order because I already know what I want. And she's like, and she's gonna watch this, by the way. And I'm just like, oh my God, just order something because I want to get out of here and I want to go back to the office so I can wash my head in freaking antibacterial soap because I have a meeting in like 20 minutes. Can't be walking into that meeting smelling like bird shit. So she's like, I don't know what I want. And I'm over there trying not to make it super obvious. So she's like, you just go. So I go and I order. And we had to wait like maybe almost 10 minutes for the food. And I was trying really hard to not move my head because every time I would move, I could feel my hair like moving and the smell would come out. And I'm just like, so anyway, I'm so sorry. I'm grossing you out. You're probably eating dinner. Anyway, so Maria had bird shit on her head this morning. Yes, it is good luck. I'm messaging Ramel going, as if this isn't enough, a bird shit on me, on my head. So I take a picture. He's like, I don't see it. He goes, but you know, I'm sorry you're having a bad morning, honey, but just know that I love you. So I'm like, oh, now he's being extra nice. What does he want, or what did he do, or what did he buy? If you are watching this, Bill Newton of Eva Beach Buy and Sell, what did my husband buy? I'm gonna have to go check the group. Ramel bought something. I know it. He's never that nice to me. So yeah, that was my morning. So as soon as we got back, I asked her to take my food to my desk while I run into the sink and scrub the crap out of my hair with freaking dial antibacterial soap. So now my head smells like cheap soap. I was literally like scrubbing it. And then I had to take rough paper towels and like dry it because I didn't want to walk out looking like a wet mop. Then I had to go to my meeting. So yeah, that was my morning. The rest of the day was okay. It's been better. Got better now that the party is done. Hi, C and C Kalani.
Is it testosterone, Paca? Are you saying that Ramel's having his period right now? He's being emotional? God, I've seen this freaking oil. I will post the recipe on what I did using this pressure cooker. So, while this thing was cooking, I left and got my nails done and came back and dinner was done. I just have to cook rice if Ramel doesn't want to eat rice. I mean, bread. But who doesn't like bread? Is it? Okay. All the men watching. Do you find that you get moody once a month? Paca, please answer. Hi, Neri. Hi, Arkley. Oh my God. Okay. I just ate that burnt crispy looking part and it's really good. It's not dry or burnt tasting. It's just, it tastes caramelized. Thank you. Look at all the wives. Look at all the wives raising their hand. Men have periods too. Or is it just a moon phase? Is it part of the moon phase? Joshua said yes. But you guys don't bleed. CNC Kalani. Oh, you're Chase's brother? Can you tell him to hurry up and send me his W-2? I've been waiting for him to get with me if he let me do his taxes. Mercury drinking Gatorade. I don't understand that. Okay, so men are moody 24/7. Women are moody too. But, okay, so we had this. I had this conversation at work. Oh my gosh, Ramel's gonna be mad. But how come it just feels like all the pressure is on the moms? Like, so last night Ramel tells me, oh, I'm going paddling practice starts up again. So just so you know, you can come home after me. And I said, let's just get this straight. I'm not coming home last and I'm not coming home after you because your happy ass comes home at 3:45. Then you take a nap or do whatever it is you do. And then you leave and you go paddle. And then I come home at 6:00. You're not coming, you know what I mean? Like, I'm not coming home after you. I'm just coming home after you after you've come home and did your thing and then you left again to go play in the water. So that doesn't mean shit to me. You know what I mean? I'm like, I'm still gonna have to come home, cook dinner, do the dishes, all the same stuff, and it doesn't matter if you came home first or last. It still falls back on me. So that don't mean nothing to me. I don't know if he felt like he was being proactive by telling me, oh, I get paddling, so I'm not gonna be home, because it don't matter, because I still do all the work. I mean, I wish I could come home and just lay down and take a nap or just be attached to my phone. That's not how it works, but moms carry that weight. See, Paca misses this Maria. Do you guys miss this Maria, the Maria that freaking roasts Ramel every time? Look, my whole thing is I'm not trying to roast my husband. I'm just talking real talk. Like, I know I can't be the only wife or the only mom that feels this way. Where it's like, oh, you can cook rice. You know, like, that's the worst thing is you come home and the same dishes you saw the night before is still in the freaking sink. And brother man was home from 3:45 and you get home at 6:00. Like, I'm not... Right? I want to go swim in the ocean. I want to come home and just rip off all my clothes and throw them all over the ground and sit down on the couch in my panty and bra and play Clash of Clans. That life is over. Husbands in general. See, we are not alone, ladies. We are not alone. And husbands, stand up. Wash a dish. Cook some rice. Now, look, I get it. Not all husbands are like that. There are some that find joy in cooking. Unfortunately, I don't think I'm married to one of them because I really would like for Ramel to find joy in cutting grass. I kind of thought that would be an innate thing because he's Filipino and Filipinos usually like to cut grass and work in the yard. But, you know, how lucky of me. He lucky that I find not joy in cutting grass, but I feel joy in seeing the grass cut. Daddy gets to go out and work. Oh my God. Clean the room. Yeah. Uh-huh. It's majority. I've only been married to one man on this planet, so I can't really say like all men are like that. I can only speak for the one that I married. And look, I ain't a freaking walk in the park. I'm a freaking nasty bitch too. That's why Ramel's deaf. But for every action, there is a reaction. So if your wife is screaming and hollering at you to the point where your ears are bleeding, I think she probably might have said it 20 times, not in a screaming voice, but you just didn't hear her because you were too busy playing Clash of Clans. Ugh. We have got to break the cycle, guys. Sometimes I wonder if this is why girls, you know, end up not staying with men and flipping to the other side. Paka loves when I talk about yard work. Oh, I feel the same way too. Sometimes I want to run away. I am, actually, in May. I am looking forward to that. Ooh, yes.
Okay. How many minutes did I say I put this in for? 10 minutes, I think.
Right there. Paka loves these savage. So, okay, real quick, Tupperware talk. The valve is up. You can hear it hissing, calling all the Filipino lovebirds. For the new people, this valve on this side has duck lips. Do not open. Paka! I should do the episode 2. Yeah, it is a new, it's a new week. I should probably do that like every Wednesday. So I have to give it about 5 to 10 minutes to depressurize. Then I can safely open. If I open it right now, I'm going to have an eruption. I'm going to Las Vegas to EDC with RJ. If you guys remember, I did that with him last year. And before people pass judgment, because I know a lot of people think it's just one huge drug fest, it is. It does not mean that we all partake in that. I don't. By the way, I'm going to meet Paka in real life in May. So in May, you're going to see a lot of Insta stories and such with me and Paka in the same frame, and it's not a split screen. I should do a, I have a YouTube channel actually. I just upload the videos that I've done on Facebook and from beyond. Like, so you'll probably find old videos of like me and my kids when they were babies. EDC, I'm so excited. Super, super duper. Hi, Kaylani. So we're just gonna keep talking story. I'm so sad. Facebook is just, I think I'm gonna start doing all my lives on Instagram now and start converting everything over, because Facebook's just been really funky. And you know, this camera right here, this Mevo camera, this thing is not cheap. $250 to $500, depending on which one you get. And it works so good when I first got it. And then I stopped doing my videos for about like 5-6 months on a daily. Now when I use it, it just freaking messes up. I don't know what's wrong with it. I even updated it and everything. And Mevo had no answer for me. They just said it may be my internet connection. And I think that's a load of crap. Hi, 69 Boricua. Oh, the cat video. Yeah. Oh, you know what? I should upload that to Face, to YouTube. I don't know if I put it on there. Gosh, I don't even know if I still have a copy. Those, that video is old. My neighbor just closed their window because I'm talking really loud to myself. Too bad. So sad. I gotta listen to their yappy. I'm not that fat. I gotta listen to their yappy dog. I'm making pulled pork, like barbecue pork. So Christine is with my mom. Emily is with Romel. So they should be coming in the door any minute because it's 7:30, which is why I had to rush, put this pork in the pressure cooker and get it started because I went out to go do my nails. Yes, I did. It's been like a year. I think the last time I did my nails was last year in May for EDC. And then I think I did it like, I kept it up for maybe 2, what you call that, fills. And then it pops it all off. I can't. So normally when I get my nails done, my first set is usually like porno style, where it's freaking stupid long. Porno nails. These are not porno nails. These are like working typewriter nails. But I usually do porno nail length because shit, if I'm going to pay $45, put as much nail as you can. But with the shortage of toilet paper and stuff, I cannot afford to get doo-doo in my long finger. You know what I'm saying? Like, so it's just make them short because I got a type and we cannot be getting dookies in there. So this color is called hazelnut. I actually remember the name. Number 70-something. Hazelnut. Right? By the way, so my boss was saying, oh, can we get hand sanitizer for every workstation? And I'm like,
Where am I supposed to get that? Because I hear that they're like, we don't have any more on the island, like Costco no more, Walmart no more. But isn't that, don't you, I've always called them porno nails. So ladies, those of you watching that get your nails done, don't you feel like extra pretty when you get your nail, like you feel better about yourself? I do. Maybe it's just me. I don't know. If you are a nail tech and you are watching this, I'm just going to say this because it was bugging me. But the guy who did my nails, he did a really good job of shaping it. And I'm a very particular person when it comes to nails. And it's just because my friends all did nails, so I know what to look for with good nails and what's not good nails. So I'm very particular when it comes to shaping. I am a traditional square cut girl. I don't do the coffin or the pointy looking like claw tip. I just do plain square. Like this is it. This is as far as I go. But I'm very particular about the shaping. The square better be nice and square. It better not be like this, you know. So anywho, I have a thing about it being cleaned underneath. So especially when it's a first set, they use crazy glue to glue the tip on. And some of them use too much glue and then it gets stuck to your skin. You guys can feel me, the ones that do nails. Come on, guy. Like, push the bush. Like, push it away from the glue because it sticks. And then when you try to file, you're filing our finger skin to death. But after you're done, take that pointy Dremel thing and just stick it underneath and just kind of because underneath there's like a lot of what's the term, is there a term for it? I know with painting it's called like overspray. There's a lot of like so like, can you guys see this? It might be hard to see on this camera, but like this, there's an extra acrylic that kind of gathers underneath. So as soon as I came home, I took my nippers or cuticle clippers and I was clipping all the excess, because what they do is they take that buffer square and they buff and then they buff underneath, but it doesn't get it all. And then you come home and it looks like you got dugyuts under your fingernail, but it's just extra acrylic. Like, come on, we're paying good money for this. Like, clean them, make them nice. Like, okay, is it just me? When you look under the nail and you can see stuff, even if it's not dirt or like grossness, it's just part of the nail, it just looks gross, you know what I mean? Like when you look underneath and it's like ew. Just saying. So do any of you guys have like just acrylic over your natural nail, like where it's all your real nail and they put the acrylic because it's grown out so much? I ask because when my nails get that long underneath, when you filled it so many times, your natural nail just naturally discolors. And it doesn't look nice, ladies. Have them file it away. Like, I have her file my natural nail away so that it's just acrylic. Because I can't do it. Yeah, have them take it out. See, I normally do, but this guy seemed, I guess, I don't know. I'm not complaining. I don't want you to think I'm complaining. I'm just saying that I'm very nitpicky when it comes to it. You do gel on your natural nail? I've been keeping my nails extremely short lately. Ooh, I've never done a silk wrap. What is that exactly? So it's your real nail and they just wrap it in something? Is it like that unique stuff for your eyelashes that make your lashes long and thick? God, this thing is so noisy. Where the hell is my family at? That's what I want to know. It's freaking 7:40. Emily needs to eat dinner. She has school tomorrow. This is why I want Romel to think outside the box. Make them freaking macaroni and cheese. Make them salmon. Like, Emily really needs to eat before they go paddling. Because look, now she's eating dinner like 8 o'clock at night. Then she got a rush. Go, you know, I'm just like, gosh. Yeah, you know, I just like, I'm not complaining. I'm just saying, yeah. Like, take that extra step and make it really nice, you know. Care and take pride in your work. So, I paid a total of $47 for my full set with gel. And yes, I got crystal gel because I'd like to have my nails shiny and pretty. Where's my freaking husband at? You'd be mad. I can't complain. And you know what I've learned to not judge the nail tech too soon. Because you know how sometimes, as they start, you can see it's like, uh-oh, it's crooked. Or, uh-oh, I don't know if this is going to come out nice. But they're not done. Because I've had that happen before where I would be like, oh, it's, look, it's not square. It's like this. I'm not finished. Okay. Sorry. Just saying. I'm watching you. City Meon Waimalu. Oh, that. I thought you meant like pissed about. But so I can't really be that pissed about it. Because if he's not taking her with him to paddling, she'd be home by herself until I get home from work. But it is what it is. But I'm like, dude, where the hell are you? Because you said 7:30. It's 7:45 already. And it's not an insecurity thing. It's that he has my kid and she needs to go to sleep. She got to get up early tomorrow. And I'm on my phone. By the way, I got a new phone, guys. I got the iPhone 11. And I switched from T-Mobile to Verizon. Because I got tired of T-Mobile dropping my damn calls. And I can't use it in my own house. Because there's like dead spots in my house. Okay, so I think it's safe to open. It's not screaming. Okay. Take forever for say goodbye. Bruh, they're going to see each other every day this week. Okay, let's see how tender the meat got after 10 extra minutes. Ooh, the thing is still boiling. Here, look. It's boiling on my countertop. Okay. Just do like this. I do like that. Okay, let's take it out. I know for sure it's gonna be really, really tender. I'm gonna, ooh, can you guys hear the sizzling? Oh yeah, I can poke it. This is not pork butt, it's pork shoulder. Can you guys hear it bubbling? Okay, I need to get this piece out. Ooh, ooh, ooh. Nay, 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 nay. And I'm gonna put the cover back on. Because I want it to stay hot for when Romel them come home. Okay, so am I the only one that thinks, where are they? Could they have gotten into an accident? Like, what's taking them so long? What's wrong? I'm sorry, but that's what I think. Like, if you say you're going to be here at a certain time. Do you see this? It's like forking tender. Ooh. And it's still sizzling. All of this was done in the microwave. If there's anybody still with me, thank you for staying with me. I know we went from like 40 viewers to like 28. But you know what? This is kind of a good number for Instagram. Oh, look. There he is. He's alive. You'd be blowing up his... See, he's lucky. I'm on my phone cooking his ass dinner. There he is. Ooh, everybody gonna give you heat now. We all waiting for you to come home and do your taste test. You like take forever at the freaking Kale. Hello. Look. Everybody giving you shit now. Look. There he is. Look, he's so scared. He cannot even spell now. I know Paka's waiting for it. Ooh, he's waiting for it. So I had mentioned it before. We have Arlo cameras now and the Ring camera. Oh my god. If you guys could like just like tune in whenever you wanted to, like the real world kind, you would see Romel would need surgery to remove his phone from his hand in front of his face. My husband is super chill. But if I push his buttons hard enough, he can turn into one of those like roid rage kind guys. Yeah, he can. I bring out the best and the worst in him. And he needs to be nice to me because a bird shit on my head earlier. And it was a pretty big shit too, just saying. Oh, here we go. Can he drive faster? Oh my god. Everybody is waiting. 7:30, you said. We all waiting for you to do a taste test. Hurry up. Look, now I really can't get off the live because... Do you guys miss this? So if... Okay, I used to do this on Facebook before and everybody would like legit go... There he is. Now we all have to stay on for another 15 damn minutes because we have to wait for him to come home and put the food in his mouth. I'm telling you. I kind of miss those days. Don't you? I know Paka does. Noemi does. See? I think I'm going to start doing my lives on Instagram now because Facebook is just driving me freaking bad crazy. Oh, by the way, Ramel, there's no rice. We're going to eat it like a Filipino sloppy joe. Yeah, he is not. He's using Siri. That's how come Siri cannot understand pigeon. See that, Ramel? You just freaking busted yourself, ding-a-ling. We're going to have a Portuguese slider. The toaster oven might take too damn long. Let me just put it in a microwave grill because that thing will take so long for preheat. Where's my knife? Radio, numb nuts. What you mean can see your bullet head again? We always could see your bullet head. What are you talking about? What? Somebody talk to him. I mean, don't let him type, but you know. Okay, so was everybody else's Monday as manic as mine's? I mean, I'm pretty sure I'm the only one that had... Oh, he did! Oh, you guys get to see his bolo head. Oh, that's what he meant. I thought he meant he went tan his bolo head. I forgot. Can you hurry up, Ramel? Holy crap. Emily needs to take a shower and eat dinner. And she... This is what dinner is. It's freaking pandesal with... barbecue pork. Like that. So I'm just gonna put this like this. We're gonna toast it. Damn. Maybe I'll flip it this way. So the cut side is down. Like that. I don't hear his car and I don't hear the rain. Who's not a beetle? Yeah. He's not. Actually, a monkey. I think, you know what, Paka? I think you were talking about the Nesbitt guy. The Nesbitt guy. If the cop pulls you over, just tell him who your wife is and they'll let you go. That's so easy. Finally is correct, Tina. Finally. God. I couldn't handle. So do any of you guys live on Oahu and is having like a big event soon? Because I'm telling you guys, Stir Beverage was the freaking shiz. Like if you're looking for bartending services, they were so awesome. I just put it in for 30 seconds because I don't want to burn the bread. Okay, 1 minute. Oh, 5 degrees for 4 days. When he ironed his hair, what are you talking about? No, ding-a-ling. When you had long hair, you look like that Nesbitt guy, the one from the monkeys. Do you guys know who I'm talking about? With the freaking big hair, and he used to always wear a beanie, and he would have those curls. I did flat iron his beard. I don't know if you guys caught that one. Oh my god, he's still not here. Frick. Hi, Gilbert. Hi, Shirelli. I'm making pulled pork with barbecue sauce. I already cooked it with the sweet baby rays. Not too much because I don't want it to be like overly seasoned, but you can add more sauce on it and then you put them in pandesal. And you have a book slider. That's what we're gonna call it. Oh my God, there's a freaking fly in here. We're gonna call it a book slider. I am gonna put more sauce on it because this bugger is freaking ono. Like that. This right here is... Oh, how do I make the crack gummies? So, like, legit, it is literally just lemon peel, but not the whole lemon. What was it called? Lemon slices? And I just put it in the chop and prep. God, that's how long it's been. Chop and prep. And you slice it up really, really, really fine and you mix it with the gummies. And any gummy works. And if you want it to be wet, you can add lemon juice. But it was good without the lemon juice. So I did it for a minute and a half. Yep, it's nice and warm. I don't know if Ramel wants his like nuk soot kind. You know, Ramel, he like everything burnt, yeah.
My salt gun is over here. But you know what? I've never needed to use it in so long because I never cooked for so long. We were eating out a lot. It was just easier. Ramel, you better freaking hurry up. Here. So I'm just going to shred the meat with the barbecue sauce and put it in pandesal. And there's my dinner. If you want, you can eat it with rice. But oh my God, this thing is going to, that fly is going to get it. I haven't used my salt gun in a while. Did you guys see it? I'm going to have to figure out how to fix my Mevo camera. Really disappointed in that. Like, for real. I'm just toasting the bread a little more because Ramel likes everything freaking burnt. Your pothead boyfriend fell in love with Kahlua pig. Oh my God, that sounds really good. Kahlua pig empanadas using crescent rolls and a micropro grill. Thank you, Michelle. You need to share your technique, Shirelli. Can you make a video on how you do that? Oh, it smells freaking good. Oh my God. This toasted pandesal smells really good. Oh, like fresh out of the oven. Do I have pickles and cheese? I'm gonna make it a little bit more toasty. I just don't wanna burn. We do have pickles, which Ramel hates. We have a couple slices of baby cheese left. Is that gonna work, Paca? By the way, I don't really care for baby Swiss. I only grabbed it because it was there and it was on sale. I like regular Swiss. This thing, like, is really, has a bite. I'll take regular Swiss. The fly is coming because this cheese is out. And if you guys saw the Instagram stories yesterday, my God, he's only passing Queens now. Hold on. Where's my freaking gun? He's only passing Queens now. This one is stuck already. Like, oh, it's not. Hello. I don't know if it's actually shooting salt. So what happens is when it gets humid and the salt gets all clumpy and like, it kind of clogs the gun. So it doesn't work. This one is the 3.0. This one is like for kill big kind bambuchas. And yes, I have two. I think that thing. Oh no, that's the one that still works. No wait. See this? I think this is the one that's broken. I knew one of them was broken. That's how long I never cook. Okay, wait. Let me load it up. Let's check it before I wreck it. Is this salt? No. And Hawaiian salt doesn't work. It has to be regular, like table salt. Hi, Sally. Pickles and cheese. So my pink one is clogged now. Freaking eras. That's what I get for leaving it in the kitchen. Get too much moisture. You have the 3.0. If you're gonna spend the money on assault, on bug assault, get the 3.0. Yep. Come on, fly. I'm telling you, every time I bust this thing out, the flies fly away. They disappear. Oh, there you. There you. Stay inside. Stay in the kitchen. I hear you. Do you guys see it? Oh, it's a big one too. How do you get a fly to like stay in one side of your kitchen? Oh, I'm gonna point it upward. I think I got it. No, I didn't. Ooh, you frick up. this guy's gonna get it. I don't like when I have to shoot it upward because it's salt. And if it goes in your eye. Hurry up, Romeo. Everybody's waiting for you. They're like, see your freaking bald head. And his bald head is white. That's what happens when you grow your hair long and you like shave on bald head. He still has this. Hi, Dre. I hear it. I can hear it. Do you guys see it when it passes in front of the phone? Come, get my food, come. I'm trying to block it from flying out of my kitchen. I might as well just whack it with a gun. What not? I went from Martha Stewart to... This thing is pissing me off, that's why. If I don't kill it, it's going to just buzz around all night long. I don't want to listen to that. Okay, just check my bread. We're not taking too damn long. Everybody's like waiting for you. Look, there's my toasted pandesal. Ooh, hot. Ow, ow. Oh, the dishwasher is done. Thank you for pressing start, Ramel. My lashes. Oh, thank you. I like having lashes. They make me feel pretty. They make me feel pretty. Makes me feel dressed up. I like it. Why are you naked? Oh my God, I'm telling you. I don't know how you're naked. Do you paddle naked? Oh, I just farted. I didn't have to say it out loud, but I did. Is your girlfriend watching? Is that why you're saying that? I mean, like, I don't understand why you're naked if you just came from paddling practice. Okay, so let's just try. Put this. I'm going to do what Paca says. Oh, but Paca, my pickles are, like, huge. They're not, like, baby pickles. We're making a Filipino. And it's only called Filipino because we're using Tasty Bakery Pandesal. I'm going to put a little bit of cheese. Shorts got wet. What do you expect? You're freaking paddling. I think you're making up lies. This thing is melting because it's warm. I only have like huge pickles. I don't have like baby pickles. What about sweet relish? I have jalapenos. What else do I have? Bagong. Is this it? Oh, I found it. It's hamburger dill chips. Is that gonna work? I don't want to slice the pickle. I hate this cheese. I'll just put a little bit. Like that. Put some mayo. Oh, you guys, I'm so gassy. Why? Oh my God. Why? Okay. Let me just grab a pickle out of here. I found pickles. I just didn't want to have to like scoop a pickle. Getting numb, this freaking fly. I'll just use these. Roma better freaking hurry up. Okay, you guys. We're going to do... Oh, there. Can you guys hear the gate? We're going to try make it the way Paca said. So, two pickles. Some cheese. And the top. Oh, I should put some more barbecue sauce in. What's wrong? Why is she crying? Okay. There. Hi, Brenda. Hurry up. Put on your clothes. Don't be coming in here freaking naked. I don't need your girlfriend getting off. Getting her jollies off.
She doesn't have a girlfriend.
Yeah. See?
Hurry up. The fly is coming for the food already.
I kind of eat bread.
Where you got that hat from? Your girlfriend gave you that.
You like my hat? My new hat.
Say hi, everybody.
Hi, everybody.
Okay, can you try the sandwich now?
Wait.
Oh, my God.
Cover up.
Cover what? Your ab.
Yeah, my keg.
Hurry up. Everybody's waiting. I added a pickle and cheese like Paca said, and Paca's a magician in the kitchen.
How the hell can you read that?
You gotta deal with it. Hi, Kaylin. Okay, Haleon.
What is it?
As if he wasn't just watching the last 20 damn minutes. Why are you hiding your head? Because it's white? Ta-da!
Back to that bullet head.
We just needed to get into shape this part because the coronavirus. That makes your... they said that it makes your mask inefficient. Oh, kininam! Romel, what the freak?
That's my...
Right? Come home from paddling and dinner is ready, just like the olden days. Mom, is it good?
Yeah. Mom, it's killers.
Thanks, Paka. Thanks, wife.
Mm-hmm. Emily, come here.
Right, I agree. Better like this or with the freaking fluffy hair, looking like you're homeless. Emily, you want to try the sandwich?
Say hi.
Come here. Do you all want to say hi to you? Hi. What words?
What words?
Homeless? Houseless.
Oh. Mom!
Good food, lose the towel. Lose the towel. Oh, what does your towel say? That's Kenny. Looks better like that. Look, they all say, hi, Emily. Emily, you want to try? You put an eagle. A bird. What's the bird? What's the bird?
Oh, no. What? No, not even eagles. Philadelphia eagles.
Don't hate. Everybody has their own whatevers. Okay. Emily, try the sandwich before Dad eats it all.
Here, try this one.
Mm-mm. What do you want to eat? That bread with butter?
Mm-mm. Macaroni salad.
Oh. Yeah, Romel is a bald eagle. What?
See?
What?
Eagles.
Yeah, he said eagles. Try it, Maria. Okay, watch out. Did you eat all the pickles? I already made macaroni and cheese. It's right here. Just warm it up. Okay, let me try. Ready, set, go. Oh my gosh, really good. You win. Paco wins again. Paco and his pickles.
There's a fly.
I know. Oh my god, so good. Okay, so
the seagulls.
I will post what I did on here. So you can see it. Yeah? Okay, we're gonna go because we were on for so long. What?
Kenny Hooney, he said, love you guys.
I know, we love you. Mom. If you guys don't know Kenny Hooney, you guys better go follow him. Mommy. He's freaking fabulous. Mommy. He's famous too. Mom. He was on TV, he does commercials. Mommy. Bye, Noemi. Brenda, breathe. You know what? I need to remind myself to breathe when I'm at work sometimes. Okay.
Dad, so long.
What?
He was talking to Auntie Penny for like
10
minutes or
20 minutes. Of course you know who was talking
about. Oh, God. Okay. You tried it? It was really good. Okay, bye, guys. We'll see you guys next time. Thanks for joining us.
It's a Dallas Cowboy. Oh, what? Oh, wait. What?
What are you reading? What?
Kumiko.
Oh, my.
Kumiko,
now, watch out. Kumiko.
Your niece is a Dallas Cowboy.
Romel's going to be adding you as a friend now. Just so you know, because he wants to go and touch a Cowboys cheerleader or whatever.
Touch a Cowboys cheerleader.
He can touch my stars, but whatever.
I have my own Cowboys cheerleader.
Hi, Richard. Okay, we're gonna go. So there it is. I'm gonna post what I did to this so you guys can try it too. Good night, everybody.